Michelle again. So today we're going to talk about daub, which is kind of the stepsister of pottery. So it's still made of kind of clay and silt, and it's fired, but it's fired only incidentally when a house burns down. So it's not purposely fired like pottery is, and it's not generally burned as hot. So it's not as nicely, solidly fired as pottery is. And I talked about this a little bit in our rough sorting video, but the big difference between daub and pottery is that daub does not have temper in it. So you can see, like, it looks kind of like pottery, but there's none of those little white speckles in there at all. It is just a solid orange, and it's got a looser texture, I guess, kind of like when you rub it, more dirt comes off because it wasn't solidly fired at a really hot temperature purposefully like pottery is. But the cool thing about daub is that it has impressions in it from where it was pressed against whatever it was pressed against. Usually people were using it to line their house walls and to line the smoke hole in the roof so that the roof wouldn't catch fire. Because in Mississippian houses, there would have been a hearth in the inside, generally toward the center, and smoke and ash and cinders would go up. You put a hole in the roof so that could get out of your house, but those little cinders might catch in the thatching of your roof. So if you line that hole with daub, which is this clay, solid, heavy stuff, that won't catch fire. And then hopefully your roof, all those cinders just go straight out and go away and don't catch your roof on fire. But the reason we have daub is because sometimes that didn't work and the houses did catch fire and then they burned and the daub therefore fired. It wasn't fired while it was on the house. It was just incidentally fired, which is great for archaeologists because we can see kind of some of the patterns of how walls and roofs were made. So you can see on this piece of daub, these impressions of probably split cane pieces going in different directions. So we can tell that some were running this way and then some were running this way. And so they were probably kind of woven together like that. You get the idea, to form a wall, and then this daub was pressed against it. And you can see how thick it is. I mean, this would have been huge on the outside of your house. It's really amazing. and I've got some other cool pieces in this one. You can see these look like the inside of split cane, but then these could be just the opposite impressions, or they could be some kind of stick or something. It's really hard to tell. Some people try to do some speciation of impressions of the different plant impressions that are found in daub. I think it's a little bit hit or miss how good the impression is, if you can tell very much about what it was. And so those would have been from walls, because you can see they're like the split cane or sticks that would form walls. But then you've got other pieces that are like this, and they just have small holes or small impressions in them. And those are probably grass impressions. And we think that what they were doing is a lot of daub, it doesn't have temper, but it's still going to dry while it's on the wall of the house. So they would mix that clay and water and silt mixture with grasses to help give it structural integrity. So when they pressed it against the wall and it dried, it would still have something kind of holding it together and it wouldn't just chip and flake off and fall on the ground. So we've got lots of pieces that have those grass impressions in there. And then also we find these grass impressions when it's pieces that are from that smoke hole on the roof, so that thatching, there's a hole cut in it, and then they press chunks of this daub into that thatching to form a barrier against the smoke and stuff that's coming out. And so you get all these just like weird looking pieces, but you can see all those little holes going through that are where grass was. And during the fire, that grass burned out of here, but it left the spaces in the daub. And I'm going to link an article that I wrote about a really cool piece of daub that I found from this. It had a fingerprint in it. And I think that's the coolest thing, that because daub, I mean, it was pressed by people onto their houses and then just left there. So someone 500 years ago, 1,000 years ago, pressed this daub into a wall and left their fingerprint, and we have it today and we get to see it. And I just think that's really neat. So I hope this was interesting for you. Not a whole lot to say about daub, except that it does give us some information about how houses were built. And I guess next week we'll talk about yet another artifact type, but that's a little quick overview of daub. Hope you enjoyed it, and I'll talk to you again next week.